Welcome to Opera Man Dallas. For today's discussion, audio will refer to CDs, MP3s, and downloads. Video will refer to DVDs, Blu-ray, downloads, and streaming. Later in the presentation, I will do a side-by-side comparison that you will want to see. In the description, you will find a picker's guide that will help you make your selection. Why buy audio only versus video? The price is about the same, from $15 to $30. Look for the better singers, not the cheaper price. Consider where you plan to enjoy the music. If you're going to be in your car, in your office, working around the house, in the yard, audio is a good choice. You do not have to sit down for 2 or 3 hours to enjoy an opera. There is also better artists are usually in the audio only production. I would assume it has to do with what it costs to hire these people. If you have a big screen TV, a lovely lady, perhaps a handsome man, a glass of wine, maybe a beer, some Crown Royal, or maybe Beefeater Gin. Come to think of it, opera goes with just about everything. This is where video shines. There are subtitles, which makes it easier to follow the plot. And afterwards, when you listen to the video, you can follow the action in the theater of your mind. Things can be done on a video that cannot be done on stage. Verdi's La Traviata with Teresa Stratus, Placido Domingo, conducted by James Levine, is produced like a movie. It's in a great ballroom. We're out in the country. We're in the rain. They have fade shots that show action that is taking place off stage. Many of the videos are merely filming of stage production. That does not mean they won't blow your mind. Deutsche Grammophon's production of Wagner's Ring of des Nibelungen, Blu-ray, $117, worth every penny, is staged using these giant rotating beams, and then they project images on top of them. So you're in the forest, you're climbing up a mountain, you're in a great hall. Now, for comparison, I'm going to use the opera Lucia di Lammermoor, which I think is the gold standard in music and singing. And it is not to say other productions are bad, but the more great singers you can get together, the better. We will start with the audio production of Donizetti's Lucia di Lammermoor, recorded in 1985. This production has it all. Four great artists. Dame Joan Sutherland, and let's face it, there's nothing like a dame. Luciano Pavarotti, the greatest tenor in the world. Some may say Enrico Caruso, but he didn't have the good audio equipment. Also, Cheryl Mills, a great baritone, and conducted by Richard Bonning. So let's hear the sound from the CD, followed by a DVD with Joan Sutherland, followed by a Blu-ray with Diana Drachma.
Thank you.
most important part of Lucia de Lammermoor is the mad scene. So let's compare Joan Sutherland's mad scene versus Diana Damrow's mad scene. Okay, we gotta have the death scene. That's the most important part of the opera. So here is Joan Sutherland's death scene compared to Diana Damrow or whatever her name is. Thank you for watching. Click on the circle on this side of the screen to subscribe.